women are enough. But we don't hear that message from the pro-abortion, pro-baby killing side. And oftentimes I'm envious of the yes all women mantra that we see on social media and among Hollywood elites. But as a pro-life woman that's kind of on the outside, even though I live in Los Angeles and I too like fashion and nail art and working out and dieting, I will never be a part of their cool crew. Because they say that they are yes all women, and they hashtag and tout it, but they are yes all women with a very big but. Yes all women but the pro-life ones. Yes all women but the post-abortive ones. Yes all women but the Down syndrome and special needs ones. Yes all women but the stay-at-home moms, but the nun, but the volunteer at a crisis pregnancy center. Since the Roe v. Wade decision, 60 million of our fellow citizens have been destroyed by the narrative that women aren't enough and that we can't handle bringing life into the world. We must teach a woman who is told that she can't do it alone. We must reach the woman who is told solely it's her body, her choice, and that leaves the man, who should take responsibility, by the way, that leaves the man and the child that are also involved in that decision out of it. We must reach the woman who is being pressured by society and peers and sometimes even family and friends. And we have to love and help the woman who feels all alone. Because I truly think that women need to know that they're enough and that they can be enough. We can rise to the occasion. And we should help them do that. We need to be encouraged that creating, growing, and sustaining life is a superpower. It's not a curse. It can alter the course of their life, but it doesn't make it worse. By all means, I think it will give their life meaning and purpose and goals and dreams to pursue and succeed at that they never could have imagined. And in many ways, it will make them better versions of themselves and give them something to live for, thrive for, and succeed for. I think it's more beneficial to educate, encourage, and empower women than it is to destroy an integral part of their unique capabilities that only they can do. Because men cannot have babies. I know that might be unpopular in some American society today, but scientifically, guys, you can help us co-create. Appreciate that. You can't have babies. We must continue to support the pro-life movement by supporting the women of our towns, our colleges, our communities, our churches, our offices, our cities, and our states. Because I truly believe that when we are pro-women, with all of our unique individual abilities and giftings, we're truly pro-life.